Simpich Heritage Center today, and I have to say that it's difficult for me to be here by this case and think about it going away. But that is one of the things we're considering as we rework some of our displays for the museum area. And I love these dolls. They're very close to my heart. Characters from The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, a story that I've known since I was a little boy. Now, my parents first did some designs from the story back in 1955. They were commissioned to design storybook characters for the Denver Public Schools and the Colorado Springs District 11 Public Schools. And what they came up with was a figure of Huckleberry Finn here with the dead cat and Tom Sawyer with the bucket of paint and his paintbrush. And these figures toured the school district. They were delivered to classrooms in these funny little wooden boxes, and the teacher would open up the boxes and pull out these storybook characters for the classroom and talk about the characters. And that's what these were for. Maybe five sets were produced. That was it. I think they're masterpieces. Now, my parents would argue with me on that, because they thought these are early designs, 1955. You know, they hadn't been doing the dolls for very many years. But I think they have a great energy. They're like three-dimensional illustrations. Now, a lot of what they did later became more sophisticated, sometimes more realistic. But these just have a wonderful, youthful energy, enthusiasm behind them, and I think they're absolutely wonderful. Later on, they decided to design some pieces that would be put into production. And in the early 1970s, they came up with a new version of Tom Sawyer. Notice the difference here between the scale and just the approach. This is as they're growing in their artistry. Both are valid. I love them both. More realistic. I have a special attachment to this version of Tom Sawyer, and I'm actually going to share a little bit about that through a play, a marionette play that I produced in 2015 that I think will explain about a birthday party that my parents held for me and about that Tom Sawyer figure that I hold in the play a little better than I can do here.
You know, birthday parties are very fine things. I can remember the party for my 11th birthday like it happened yesterday. We had about 10 or 12 friends over from school and church, but the guest of honor, well, one of the best friends I've ever had, was not delivered by his parents to our front door, but was rather delivered by my own parents in a wrapped package. Well, after everyone arrived, we piled into several station wagons and were driven over to the Cave of the Winds in Manitou Springs. It was to stand in for another cave, McDougal's Cave, the climactic setting of a certain great adventure book. This book was the theme of my birthday party. Well, after the cave tour, in which no one got seriously lost, we returned home for cake, ice cream, and presents. And little did I know that the title character of this book was to be my special, my big gift. I opened the box and couldn't believe it. Tom Sawyer himself, complete with paintbrush, bucket of whitewash, and bandaged sore toe. Tom, given to me in every sense by my mother and dad. the great quests and escapades we shared together had actually begun several years before. My parents would take turns reading a chapter of The Adventures of Tom Sawyer to me each night. I can remember at least three times through the book. And while Tom's ingenious exploits and misdeeds, his agonizing defeats and impressive victories came to life in my imagination, my parents also supplied a most vivid 3D illustration as they created the players from the story for their Simpich character doll business. And now they had given me a Tom Sawyer of my very own, fashioned by their own hands. What a friend to place on the shelf just next to the book.
So as you can see, I had a very special connection to this guy, a friendship actually. Now my wife and I produced a version of Tom Sawyer for the Marionette stage back in 1989, and we were actually hidden behind backdrops, and the characters told the story. I did have a figure of Mark Twain that kind of came in and out once in a while. And after we did that for a few years, those characters were put away, and I wasn't sure I would ever use them again. But in 2015, I decided to set about to readapt that show as a one-man play, and that was what you just saw as an excerpt. And what I wanted to develop was my relationship with this literary character, this friendship really, as he explores, you know, has all these adventures. And then also as an adult, you know, just kind of my thoughts on Mark Twain as an author, as a literary artist. And so in this play that I produced, I actually have there's kind of a triangle between Tom, myself, and Mark Twain. And that's really developed in this one-man show. It was a really fun play to do and really celebrates the story. I don't always agree with everything that Mark Twain does and says, and we kind of bring that out. We kind of have some discussions. By the end of the show, we actually have an argument in the cave where we're really disagreeing, but that's all part of just engaging with this wonderful book. So back to the early 70s, my mother did a version of Becky Thatcher, and she was put into production when the doll business was in my home growing up, and this is Huckleberry Finn. Now, the early years he was produced, he had the dead cat, just like this Huck Finn. A different sculpture, but same idea. He's holding the dead cat. I think they decided somewhere, maybe 7 or 8 years into production, they would replace the dead cat with a fishing pole, which was also very appropriate. And they actually used wire. I remember I used to work on these. It was something that was one of the things that was my job in the doll workshop, was to take pieces of wire. That's what the stick is made out of, so it won't break easily. Glue on little threads around there to make it look a little more like a stick, paint it, and then attach the string. So I worked on that for a while in the workshop. These are wonderful dolls. They were produced in limited numbers for many, many years and are great for being displayed during the summertime. Just wonderful figures. Now in 1990, my parents were commissioned to design 3D sculptures of Norman Rockwell's illustrations of Tom Sawyer. And this was a really exciting thing for my parents. I guess around that time, they were putting out, the Postal Service was putting out an official Tom Sawyer 8-cent stamp. And it was going to be available for people. It would have an illustration of Tom painting the fence by Norman Rockwell. And as part of that whole celebration, the Danbury Mint wanted to produce 3D sculptures of various scenes that Norman Rockwell had illustrated. So my dad set about to sculpt with a clay material called Super Sculpey, Tom painting the fence using Norman Rockwell's illustration as his guide. And he just basically created a 3D version of it. And as you can see here, it was produced in wood also. This is actually a wood carving that a special instrument carved. So it was a little smaller here. I think the other painted sculpture is the largest it was done. And then my mother helped out on this one. This is Tom Lost in the Cave. It's a 3D sculpture of the Norman Rockwell illustration. My dad sculpted Tom and my mother sculpted Becky. They always worked very well together. Their styles were completely complementary, and they became more and more so through the years. What a project! My wife and I were in Hannibal, Missouri a few years ago. We went to a museum there. That's the kind of the headquarters for Mark Twain's boyhood home and the Tom Sawyer Museum and all kinds of wonderful things there in Hannibal, Missouri to celebrate the story. We went into one of the museums and there was my dad's sculpture in the museum of Tom painting the fence. Also at the museum are some of the original illustrations that Norman Rockwell painted. They weren't very large, just about this big. Magnificent illustrations, and very exciting time to be able to do that for the Danbury Mint. And then these were also sold in the doll shop. Now, somewhat later, my parents attempted another version. This was their own concept of Tom and Becky lost in the cave. And they actually created a platform with stalagmites and a burned out candle that Becky has set down there. And now just Tom has his candle lit. And this was produced also. A very elaborate piece that was produced in very limited numbers. Now back to the Danbury Mint project. I also wanted to show you another sculpture that my dad did of Huck with the dead cat. And this is taken directly from an illustration that Norman Rockwell produced when he did the illustrations for the book. And Huck is holding the cat. And then there was a separate sculpture my dad did of Tom bent over looking at the cat. And it's directly taken from Rockwell's illustration. Just a wonderful 3D interpretation, which is really quite a project actually, because, you know, my dad didn't get to see the other side of what Rockwell had done. So I think he did a great job on this. Wonderful, wonderful pieces. I have such special memories of my parents working on these pieces, and they were displayed in our home for many years. And as I share in my 2015 production of the play, of the story, that my parents read this to me, you know, over and over, maybe three times. We went all the way through the book. And then I read it to my children several times also, took them to Hannibal, Missouri, and showed them the museum and all the wonderful things there, went through the cave. So wonderful pieces to celebrate summertime and celebrate a wonderful story that Mark Twain shared. So exciting to have this. It will not be easy to say goodbye to this one, but we have other plans for other exciting things. And the museum and Heritage Center is just not large enough to have everything out at the same time. So that may happen sometime soon, but it's great to share these pieces with you. Very special.